fish tapeworm. It is also called broad tapeworm or Diphyllopotrum latum. This one is largest human tapeworm. How we will get this infection? Through when we are eating raw or undercooked freshwater fish. That one is infected with Diphyllopotrum latum. Clinical features: asymptomatic or long-lasting infection. Common manifestation occur diarrhea, abdominal pain, vomiting, weight loss, fatigue, constipation and discomfort. It will mainly causes anemia, vitamin B12 deficiency. Then first one is definitive host, human only, human, dog and cat. These are the things, definitive host. Why we are calling definitive host means where sexual reproduction occur. That name is called as definitive host, here human. First intermediate host, cyclops. Here no reproduction occur, non-reproductive form of parasite, because the cyclops intestine are small one. Then second intermediate host, fish. This one is pleosarcoid larva. That means this one is infective form. It only causes infection to human being. Then in this life cycle, four things very important. First one is pleosarcoid larva. That means elongated infective larva of some tapeworm, usually occur in muscles of fish. It is present at muscle of fish. Second one is egg. This one is zygote form. Third one is coracidium. Here this one have ciliated first stage aquatic embryo. This larva one is immature, not causing any infection. Then prosarcoid, first parasite larva of some tapeworm. Now we see about life cycle. This one is fish. This muscle occur in this pleosarcoid, that means infective form of larva. It is otherwise called as parenchyma. Then when human will take this fish by inadequate cooking or raw fish, it will enter to intestine. After that it will develop into adult worm. After that mating will occur, it will release the egg into the stool sample. This one is unembryonated egg. First stage aquatic embryo, it having 6 hooks. When it will reach to water, after that only development will start. First stage name is called as coracidium. Here it have ciliated stage, then it will move to water. Then second stage larva is injected, it will develop. This second stage larva is injected by cyclops. Now this larva inside of the cyclops. This cyclops eaten by small fish. Then this small fish is eaten by big fish. Then this fish muscles having this pleosarcoid form, that means infective form. Then it will take human. Cycle will repeat. Morphology. Adult worm composed 3 segment. Head part, then neck, third one is lower body. Neck, head part having hook and scarlex part. Then neck part, it will attach to the proclitid part. This one is immature, here won't reproduction will occur. This mature proclitid part only reproduction occur. This fish tapeworm length 10 meter in long. Adult can lay egg 1 million egg per day. Then laboratory diagnosis, microscopic examination of stool. So egg and proclitic segment we will observe by using microscopic technique. Then RFLP, restriction fragment length polymerization, and PCR also used. Then treatment, praziquantel and nicolosamide. Then gastrographin contrast medium using like X-ray only. Diagnostic tools for the treatment, introduced into duodenum, visualize that parasite, cause it to be TH attached and pass the whole worm.